For me as a kid, I had dreams bigger than anybody else could ever dream, and I wanted to be the greatest. I wanted to be the best.
A champion is someone who is pushing the limits of their human potential. And it doesn't have to be physical. It could be emotional, it could be psychological. Champions have clearly defined goals and a plan to get there. If you have a goal and you want to make it happen, you got to realize that it is 1,000 small decisions made day after day after day after hour that get you there. Successful people make a habit of doing things that failures don't like to do.
The greats do things when they don't always want to. And I think that's what separates good from great.
Now, everybody wants something today. They want immediate gratification. Swimming is all about delayed gratification. You see Michael Phelps or anybody who performs at a high level, well, they're just talented, right? They have this 7-foot wingspan, flexible ankles, some heart that's 3 times the size of everybody else. I don't know about that one, but I know that during this process, Michael Phelps went for 6 years without ever missing a day of training, 365 days a year. He insisted on it because he wanted to be the best ever.
I always wanted to be the first Michael Phelps because I wanted to do things differently than everybody else. So for me, when I went through a span of 5 or 6 years where I didn't miss a single day of training, 365 days a year, that made me different. I got 52 extra days each year. I was willing, I think, to make sacrifices.
Champions produce predictable and normal results in abnormal and unpredictable environments. That's the essence of Olympic competition. They have the ability to concentrate on what they're doing when things around them don't go as maybe they had seen it coming.
I mean, the biggest thing I think that really separated me through my career was my mental game, everything that was in between my ears. I eventually got to the point where I was competing against myself because I was so hard on myself. For me to improve, I had to get stronger mentally, and I had to find a way to do it.
Visualization is key in any sort of goal-oriented activity. When you set a goal, you're basically creating a picture of yourself in a different way. It's a different you. And what happens is your subconscious and your conscious will move to the mental picture that is strongest. So if your picture is, I'm not all that good, but I'm a pretty good swimmer, that's the way you're going to be. If your picture is, I'm the Olympic champion, I will do whatever it takes to get there, I will think about it all the time, I will visualize myself doing it, I will see myself doing it, that's where things start to move.
When I would visualize, I visualize every single, I mean, getting up to a meet, I would visualize probably a month or so in advance just of what could happen, what I want to happen, and what I don't want to happen. Because when it happened, I was prepared for it. So, when I go into 2008 and in the 200 fly, my goggles fill up with water the first 25 and I swim blind for 175 meters, I revert back to what I did in training and counted my strokes.
Champions value the process more than any particular outcome. You can't control what the other people do. There are a lot of variables that you cannot control. How about if you just focused on accomplishing what you set out in your plan? And if you do that and you're engaged in the moment, the other stuff takes care of itself.
When I did have a defeat, I'm obviously very quiet. I'm very upset. And I know that when I'm training, that's still in my head. Those replays still play in my head because I don't want that feeling again. I never want the feeling of defeat. And that's what kept me going and kept me going harder and harder every day.
So that's what champions do. They focus on the things they can control. They have a plan, and they work on every day making it a little bit closer to the plan. One step, one step, one step.
That's why I went to practice every day. That's why I worked as hard as I did every day, because I didn't want anybody to beat me. I wanted to stay on top of the mountain as long as I could, and if somebody wanted to knock me off, I was ready for a challenge.
If you look at things in perspective and you find your dream, you can accomplish some amazing things. The process is all the same. And I hope that all of you will find your dream and get to work.
Whatever you want to do in life is possible.
And that's been something that I've been able to realize firsthand. You know, as a 10-year-old kid, would I ever think I'd be sitting here? I've been able to do everything I've ever wanted in sport. Would I say I'd be able to do it 10 years ago? Probably not. But I didn't give up. I think that's the biggest thing. And you know, if it was easy, everybody would be doing it. There are always going to be ups and downs, but I think it's really how you really, you know, get back on your horse and keep going forward. And I think the biggest thing that I've always said is never give up. I never have, and nobody ever should. If they want something bad enough, they'll get it. They have to work for it. Yeah, it's not going to be easy. But if you want it bad enough, they'll do whatever it takes to get there. So thank you guys for coming out, and I wish you all the best of luck.